Welcome to Module 4, Other Techniques of Differentiation. We have the Lecture 4.1, the Implicit Differentiation. Recall from Lecture 1.2, Types of Functions. A function may be expressed explicitly or implicitly, that is, if y is isolated and solved in terms of x, it is an explicit function of x. Otherwise, it is implicit. Given an implicit function in the form f of x comma y is equal to 0, to obtain the derivative of y with respect to x, we have the following steps. First, differentiate both sides of the equation with respect to the independent variable. Second, apply the rules for differentiation. And we have here the differentiation of y raised to n. We will just simply use the formula for the power. And then third, solve for the derivative of y with respect to x explicitly. Let's have the first example. We have here 2x squared plus 4y squared is equal to 4x plus y. The first step that we're going to do is to differentiate both sides of the equation with respect to x. All right, for the first term, we have 4x. Take note, huwag kayong maglalagay ng equal sign dito, ha? Dahil we already have an equal sign here, so there's no need, and it is incorrect, actually, to put an equal sign everywhere because we already have an equal sign in the middle. Next, we have 8y, y prime. Now, take note, how is that? The derivative of this is equal to 4 times the derivative of y squared. So using the power formula, we have 2y and then multiplied by the derivative of the base with respect to x. This is the base. So dy dx is equal to y prime also. So we will use the symbol y prime because it is more simpler compared to dy by dx. Okay? After that, we have here 4 and then plus y prime. We are going to isolate y prime, meaning to say we are going to solve for y prime explicitly. So, dapat lahat ng mga may y prime magkakasama. And then, yung mga wala, magkakasama din. So, we have 4 minus 4x. Okay, solving for y prime, we have here factoring 8y minus 1. We have... Unahin natin yung negative. So, negative 4x plus 4. Divide both sides of the equation by 8y minus 1. And at the same time, let us isolate the negative sign. Let's put that there from the numerator. So, we have 4x minus 4. Okay? And then over, all over, 8y minus 1. This is now the final answer. Example 2, we have tangent of the quantity x squared minus 2xy is equal to y. Differentiating implicitly with respect to x, this is entire u, it is inside the tangent. So the derivative of that is equal to secant squared of the same angle. Okay, and then multiplied by the derivative of the angle. It is binomial, so... Be careful, we have 2x. And then, how about the derivative of 2xy? Here, this is equal to 2 times the derivative of xy. Xy, we have two variables there, x and y. So, this takes the form u times v, product rule. So, this is equal to 2 times u x dv y prime plus v y times du y. So we have 2 times the quantity xy prime plus y. So let us put that here. So this is equal to minus 2. Distribute na din natin 2xy prime minus 2y. Okay, equals y prime. Okay, we have a y prime here. So, but we have to multiply it there before we isolate it. Okay, so this becomes, i-group natin, 2x minus 2y, and then we have secant squared of x squared minus 2xy, and then tapos i-distribute natin doon sa 2xy prime. So we have minus 2xy prime times secant squared of x squared minus 2xy equals y prime. Okay, so we can now move the 2xy prime to the other side together with the y prime. So we have factoring, we have 2 times the quantity 2x minus y, secant squared of the quantity x squared minus 2xy is equal to, at the same time, let us factor it out. We have y prime times the quantity, magiging positive na tong negative 2xy prime sa kabila. So we have this one. And plus 1. Saan galing yung 1? Dito, coefficient ng y prime. Okay, divide both sides of the equation and also switching the left and right side of the equation. We have the final answer here. So we have 2 times the quantity x minus y, secant squared of the quantity x squared minus 2xy, all over we have 2x secant squared of the quantity x squared minus 2xy plus 1. Okay, wala tayong pwedeng ma-cancel out kasi may binomial tayo sa ilalim. So, this is the final answer. Example 3, cotangent of x over y plus tangent of y over x is equal to 2. We're going to get the derivative right away. So we have negative cosecant squared of x over y. Let's put a parenthesis. And then multiplied by the derivative of x over y. And then plus the derivative of tangent is secant squared y over x. And then multiplied by the derivative of y over x is equal to 0. Okay. Scratch, ano derivative ng... Okay, dito na lang natin ilagay. The derivative of x over y. We are going to make use of the quotient rule. We have y squared on the denominator. VDU minus u dv. Okay. This is VDU minus u dv. Okay. The derivative of the denominator is y prime. And then for the other one, the derivative of y over x, this is equal to v du minus u dv, and then all over x squared. Okay, let's put that here. We have negative cosecant squared x over y, and then multiplied to the derivative, we have y minus xy prime all over y squared, and then plus secant squared of y over x, and then multiplied to the derivative xy prime minus y all over x squared is equal to 0. Let us clear the fractions, multiplying both sides of the equation by the LCD of the denominators. Okay, kailangan kasi mawala ito so para mas madali yung trabaho natin. So dito, multiply din tayo. X squared, y squared. Para mawala ito. The resulting equation would be, for the first term, we have x squared. And then unahin na natin to y minus xy prime. And then we have negative there. And then cosecant squared of x comma y. Pwede na rin natin alisin yung parenthesis. And then after that, we have y squared times xy prime minus y secant squared y over x is equal to 0. Isolate natin yung mga may y prime. Okay, lahat ng mga may y prime dapat matitira lang sila dito sa kabila. Okay. Factoring, ito na lang yung matitira. Okay, factoring, we have y prime times the quantity. Ito lang naka-highlight. And then plus y squared x secant squared y over x. Secant squared y over x. And then sa kabila, we have ano yung mga walang y prime. So we have positive x squared y. Don't forget to multiply x the cosecant. Don't forget to multiply the cosecant. And then we have, oh, we have plus. Okay, ito yan. We have plus y cube secant squared of y over x. Okay, dividing both sides of the equation, we have y prime is equal to, factor din natin, we have y times the quantity x squared cosecant squared x cosecant squared x over y plus y squared secant squared y over x. And then sa ilalim, factor din natin yung x. So, x times the quantity x squared cosecant squared x over y plus y squared secant squared y over x. Magka-cancel. So, the final answer is y over x. So, eto magka-cancel. Parehas na parehas sila. So the final answer is y over x. Example 4, we have x squared is equal to y minus sine squared y. Differentiating both sides of the equation, we have 2x is equal to y prime minus for sine squared y, this is equal to sine y, quantity sine y squared. Okay, this is not equal to sine y squared. Okay, magkaiba yan. Okay, this implies that our given is u raised to n. Using the power rule, we have 2 sine y and then cosine y times y prime. Y is that? So this is n u raised to n minus 1 and then this is the derivative of u with respect to x. Okay. We have 2x equals y prime minus 2y prime sine y cosine y. Okay, we have here, pagbalik na rin natin and also i-factor na natin, we have y prime times the quantity 1 minus 2 sine y cosine y is equal to 2x. Okay, so this is, if you are familiar with the identity, we can express this as, oh, we have here y prime is equal to 1 minus sine 2y equals 2x. So y prime, therefore, is equal to 2x over 1 minus sine 2y. Example 5. We have ln of xy plus 2x plus 5y is equal to 9. For the first term, ln of xy, this one is a product inside the ln function. So meaning to say, we can split this as ln x plus ln y. And then plus 2x plus 5y is equal to 9. So this is easier to differentiate. Okay, next, differentiating implicitly with respect to x, we have 1 over x plus y prime over y. Okay, the derivative of y is y prime. And then plus 2 plus 5y prime is equal to 0. So, isolating the terms with y prime. And then those that do not have will be transferred to the other side of the equation. Okay, let us clear the fractions. Multiply both sides of the equation by xy para mawala yung denominators. So, this would become xy prime and then plus 5xy, y prime is equal to negative 2xy minus y. Next, factoring y prime times the quantity x plus 5xy. And then we have, ilabas natin yung negative. And also yung y, pwede rin natin ilabas. So we have negative y times the quantity 2x plus 1. Okay. We have y prime is equal to negative y times the quantity 2x plus 1. And then all over, yung x plus 5xy, meron ding common factor na x. So we have, and also unahin natin yung isa pa, 5y plus positive 1. So this is the final answer. You have reached the end of this discussion. You are highly encouraged to answer the exercises provided at the end of this video courseware.